Hello everybody and welcome back to some Fallout 4 It's Not Real Automatron DLC. You find old Mad Tina here hanging around in the middle of the night in a rainstorm with my upgraded robot. This is about as good as I'm going to get him. This is X95. I've mentioned the name of this. It's got Power Claw, Lightning Gun, huge amount of electrical doodads and whatnots strapped onto his back, and protection on this. I thought I changed the protector on legs back from being a Soltron that they were in the last video, because he had a habit of like legging it ahead and disturbing things and running into mines and such like that. So I've modded it up. So he's only got a couple of Soltron parts, a couple of protector parts, and a rubber brain head. Anyway, we are here because we need to speak to Ada over here, because we picked up Jezebel's head.
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment.
Okay.
There you go. Still in one piece.
Thank
I'm
you.
Not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
Well, we still need it.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the Mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the Mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
I agree. We really don't have time for any more mistakes.
You're right. And I'm sorry. Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
I don't really have time for this right now.
Yes. You're right, of course. I'm sorry. I won't bring it up again. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
Yes, indeed. So, I now need to go and build a new body for Jezebel. So, pop around here and to my Mechanist workstation. Build a new automatron. Which requires 6 rubber, 6 circuitry, 9 ceramic, 11 aluminium, and 8 adhesive. Now, this is all I've got on here, so let's quickly put them together. So we want Jezebel's head. Yep, let's put that on there. I don't want any head armor, I don't need that. Torso. Let's give her a robo brain torso. Since she is a robo brain, let's give her her own robo brain torso. Do I have armor? Have I got... Oh yeah, I can stick that mod on there, that's fine. Do I have any rear armor mods I can just straight attach? No. Protectron armor is okay, and protectron armor on that side as well. And let's give her assault on legs. Do I have any armor? I don't think I've got any armor plating I can slap on there easy enough. It looks cool. But yeah, I don't have any that I can put on. No waist armor that I can stick on either. Have I got? I think I. Oh no, hang on. I might have some weaponry I can stick on. Oh yeah, yeah, I can stick a vice grip on there. Yeah, I can stick the flamer on there. And that will have to do for you, Jezebel. There you are. I've built you a body out of bits and pieces that I once used to build at X95. How are you doing?
Interesting. This body you've selected for me isn't quite what I had envisioned, but it will have to suffice.
So sorry, Your Highness. The royal tailor has been quite ill, and I'm afraid the task fell to me instead.
If you're attempting to use sarcasm as an intimidation tactic, I'm afraid you're wasting your time. Look, it's obvious we don't care for each other's company, which suits me just fine. So, why don't you ask me everything you wanted to know, and then I'll be on my way.
You aren't stuck here. You could leave if you wanted.
You've created an interesting stalemate between us. Something I didn't expect you to be capable of. I'm impressed. It's been a long time since I've been outsmarted. Why don't you go ahead and ask me your questions?
Tell me everything you know about the Mechanist.
Now there's a fascinating subject. The Mechanist. Amazingly adept at programming. A veritable genius with electronics. I'm not surprised you're interested. I've been dutifully carrying out the Mechanist's instructions to help the people of the Commonwealth for quite a long time.
Helping the people of the Commonwealth? You?
Absolutely. It's my primary directive. The Mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging a laughably fragile life. It's the most efficient way to assist them. Any other effort to help tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
I can't deal with this. Just tell me how I can find the Mechanist.
Very well. Assisting a human to the best of my abilities only affords a 25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting will die from something beyond my control. Therefore, it's better to hasten the human's death and put them out of their likely chance of misery than to deplete my limited time. It's actually quite elementary. But given your minimal intellect, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised you don't understand.
Right, that there was a unavoidable conversation. Even though I said, look, I don't care what you're doing, just tell me how to help get to the Mechanist. She was all, oh, yes, but, well, you see, for, and I want to kill people because that's the best way to helping them. And it's like, I don't care.
Can we stop with the petty bickering and just get to the part where you tell me how to access the Mechanist facility?
I promised to answer your questions. And unlike humans, I don't have the capacity to lie. It's rather simple, really. In order to gain entry to the Mechanist facility, you're going to need to outfit one of your robots with an MSAT modification. I'll upload the plans to your Pip-Boy device. There. I've fulfilled my portion of our agreement. Perhaps I'll remain here for a while and see how things resolve between yourself and the Mechanist. Purely for my own amusement, of course. I suspect you'll have quite a tale to tell once you return. But then again, I'd be surprised if you ever return at all.
Right, that's it dealt with. So now I'm back off to speak to Ada again.
Hey, Ada.
I trust you've completed your business with Jezebel. I hope she wasn't too difficult.
Is there a chance these robots could be misinterpreting orders?
Yes, I've considered the possibility. The contradictory nature of the Mechanist's broadcasts are troubling. But the truth is, regardless of intent, the Mechanist needs to be stopped. These robots are too much a threat. Were you able to discover how to gain access to the Mechanist?
I need to outfit a robot with something called an MSAT. Jezebel gave me the plans.
A custom modification that acts as a key to the Mechanist facility. Very smart. In fact, chances are high the MSAT may be required for multiple access points, like a robot identification card. As for my task, I was able to decrypt the signal with the final radar beacon. The source is coming from a Robco sales and service center, most likely a front for a larger operation. It's time to take the offensive. Have you formulated a plan?
It's time to confront the Mechanist.
I hope you're allowed the opportunity. I too am curious as to what the Mechanist would have to say. Now, if you're ready, I believe you have an MSAT to install. Would you allow me to assist you on this mission?
No. Stay here.
I understand. I wouldn't want my own personal investment to cause any complications.
There really isn't much point in having Ada coming along, unless you don't want to build your own robot. Because all the parts, in the first like three missions you get, which are just go over here, kill this robo brain, go over here, kill that robo brain, kill the stuff around them. You get practically all the parts to make your own robot. I mean, X95 here, the leg armor and the electrical armor down there, that's all the stuff that I built. The rest of that was just entirely salvaged. Anyway, special mods, let's stick that MSAT on you. And that's been updated. Right, I'll back in a moment again and go there. Now I have actually done, or tried to do, the Mechanist mission several times and failed each and every time so far. So what I'm going to do is I am going to try and game the system, because I think I actually stand a chance of doing that and thus winning that way, rather than trying to do it fair, because the Mechanist isn't fair. So I'll meet you at the Robco Sales and Service Center. Right, so I've got everything I need. I'm going to go with the shotgun on this one because it basically almost does double damage for my combat rifle, plus it's got a faster, I don't know, it's a slightly slower firing rate. But yeah, more damage, slightly slower firing rate, but not enough to warrant use of the other gun, really. Plus it's got a silencer on it, which means I get to do my free silence shots. Well, I say free silence shots, you know, it's like 2.5 times damage silence criticals. And yes, I do know I could have gone down and had better agility, got a ninja and be doing a hell of a lot more damage with this gun. But ninja is really suited for melee, and preferably VATS melee, which is what I'm not using either of. Right, here we are. X95 with all his sparky. Let's see. So it seems, that's just literally a terminal there. Seems to all be in one piece. I won't have a shopping basket. Is there anything in the cash register? No, nothing in the cash register. I've stocked up on bits and pieces, so I don't need to go around collecting all these. And tripwire. One tripwire disabled. I don't know anything from there. As you can see, there's not really a lot going on.
Open this.
So I'll wait for X95 to come down here, spark the spark. And while it's doing that, let me just... Oh, I've loaded myself! Yeah, I loaded down myself with so much stuff that I've overloaded myself. So, hey, you remembered it, excellent. Geez, look at the amount of doors. Look at the amount of doors this guy needs. Right, so this is probably going to be going slower until I drop something. In fact. Yeah, I have 17 frag mines. Let's hang on then. Because I think you guys can handle me just going slowly for a little while until I start lobbing grenades, at which point I'll then speed up again.
Incoming robot detected.
I want to avoid that as a radiation barrel. And all the doors again. Because reasons. Now we have what appears to be some kind of shop. Don't quite know what's there. Ah yes, there's this thing. So I'll just wait for them to go on their way. Probably recognise this from the trailer. I can't get through that. Yeah, going through there is a bit dangerous. So, there is a back way, just come around here. All the way through this nice ruined area. And you get a decontamination control terminal. So I just need to wait for X95 to get here. Because I've equipped him out with... Ah, there he is.
Can't break the code.
Come on.
Think you can unlock that terminal?
Understood.
Yeah, I've equipped him with a hacker device.
Requested task. Attempt failed. Repeating. Task complete.
Thank you. Turret control. Turrets are all offline. Good. Decontamination arch control. Tampering detected. Any attempt to hack, modify, or alter Mark 11 decontamination is strictly prohibited and made void wanted. Activate the mist. I don't know what that does for me, but activating it anyway. Can't hear anything, so state's busy, okay. Anything else I can do on here? Security door control. Security doors are unlocked.
Error. Electrical fault in sensor array. Sensors offline.
Excellent. Now I can just go right the way back through here. So there's a couple ways through. You can completely bypass that, because there's a door on the other side there that's locked, and you can just lockpick it and go straight through. Or if you've got, we'll hear decon, thank you. If you're a good hacker, you can hack the terminal and turn these off, which deactivates, means these things don't come on. You go straight through to first checkpoint.
The Scourge of the Commonwealth has used my own technology against me. You may have gained access to my sanctum, but you'll need better skills than that to defeat me.
And I have them, don't you worry.
Neutralized. Recommend immediate repairs to primary systems to ensure continued operation.
This is the first security checkpoint he's got.
Threat analysis, green. Security operation successful. Resuming normal operation.
Excellently done. Let's see, any ammo over here? Right away to cruise from town to a rocket ship? No. Robo brain left arm. Yes. Although I don't know if these... I'll take them all anyway, because I can slap them on stuff later. Laser beta wave tuner. What on earth is that? It's a mod. Alright. We're going to show where we left on. Right, and we need to go through here. There's nothing over that way.
Over here.
So this kind of sets precedent for what you should be experiencing or expecting to experience in the Mechanist lair. You know, small checkpoints, potentially with a lot of guys hanging around in them, and a fair amount of space between them.
Sweet.
20 rounds behind a locked crate. All right, well, I'll take it. It's not really going to do me any good, because it's not even rounds I use. Alright, and onwards we go. And yeah, I'm going to start lobbing grenades so I can, clear up some space in my inventory and start moving faster. No, that's just a piece of ruined tech. So generator here. There's a couple of Protectron pods that are open. Okay, well, that's him dead. Apparently there's a couple of bots over there somewhere. And I just got one. Pretty impressive. Don't know where X95's gone though. He's around here somewhere, I assume. Sentry legs, yeah, let's take those. He's gone. Maybe he's gone off over there or something, I don't know. Oh, it's the turret that was over there, okay. I don't think there's anything interesting around here. No, some 32 rounds. Some more glue in there, most likely. Oh, yeah, duct tape. So where you gone, Knight? Are you under... Are you under this, 95? Where have you gone? I don't know... Okay, I don't know where my robot's gone. Let's just make sure he's not wandered off over here. No. Okay. Can I rest or just wait for an hour and see if he comes back? Out of the way, I want to sit in this chair. Oh, I'll just sit on you then, okay. No, okay, 95 is nowhere to be seen. He might have potentially fallen through the world. I'll quickly reload the previous save point and come back to here, so it'll just be a moment for you. Right, we're just back heading to this area again. I'm not going to bother getting that, so pointless. 95 is still with me. And here we are, back at this scrap again.
Thank you.
Well, there you are, that dealt with. There's a gun turret over there that I can't quite get at by the looks of it. I think I've already got a sentry here, haven't I? Checktron.
Alert! Hostile remains at large. Recommend non-combatants seek secure location.
Very wise suggestion, but I'm not a non-combatant. However, I am going to have to switch over to the longer range weapon. There we are, that's that down. Back to the shotgun. Oh yeah, flying all over here. It's been throwing grenades again. I've got a cartridge yet. Whoa, where are you going? Let's quick save this shiz. Right, there's two more. Now, I can activate these, but they do go hostile, so there's not much point in activating them. So let's just keep on moving on. Junk bot somewhere nearby. Duct tape in there. More duct tape, more duct tape. Never have too much duct tape. Aha! Ah, legendary, okay. Now this is part of my gaming the system thing. Because when you start off one of these, you get a choice of working on the robot you've got with you, which would be X95, or building a new automatron. And if you build a new automatron, as far as I'm aware, unless they've literally just patched it, it will just pop out and roam around the area you build it. And it will still be classed as a follower. Ah, okay, I'm thinking too much now. So it'll still be classed as a follower, but it will be essential. So it cannot actually die. Sure, it can get beaten up, but that's about the extent of it. So, come on 95, just up the stairs. There's a legendary up here, so we're going to have to try and have our wits about us when taking him on. And by wits about us, I mean, here's three frag grenades. Must have buggered both his legs by the looks of it. Hey, he's mutated, right? Give it the full whack. There we are, it's dead. Right. Oh yeah, I forgot. Legendary robots have an atomic detonation. Whoops. Never mind, it wasn't that long ago since I last saved it. Whee! Right, back we go. Let's get all that duct tape again. Duct tape. Duct tape, duct tape. Ceramics, overloaded, never mind, I won't be for long because I'll just be lobbing grenades. And while I don't have explosives expert, I have actually managed to pick up a fair few grenades on my journeys, so it's not that hard to find new ones by the looks of it. Okay, yeah, death laser to the face. Try it again. I was not expecting the death laser. So back we go again, once more, legendary junk pot upstairs. duct tape, duct tape, duct tape. That. Let's quick save now. Right. Now they're both there. So, I reckon. Should be all I need. Yeah, there they are, they're dead. Or at least one of them is dead.
Alert, hostiles in.
Which one's still alive? Oh, it's the legendary still alive. Is there much left to him? Yes, there is, okay. Legendary junk bot rather than a legendary assault bot though. Okay, something... I'm not getting lucky with these, it just kind of blop 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 blop. Ow, okay. Oh well, fourth time's the charm, eh? Ragnall the robot! Right, I'm just going to move out here. And nothing in the electronic. Wait for it to calm down a bit, because it's right there. And if I blow it up right there, that's probably going to affect all down here with the explosion as well. Shit, is it coming downstairs? It is. Fifth time? I die a lot in these, I'm sure you've noticed. If I was going in with like power armor or something, or I'd actually built a very specific combat build, then I'm sure I'd be doing far better. But as it stands, I'm not, because I haven't. Because I've built a charisma build, and I'm going in guns blazing with a charisma character. Well, that worked. Ah! Too close to the explosion! I wonder how I can get past that explosion. Can I literally take it out and then sprint past it? Just backing up right into the corner isn't doing me any favours by the looks of things. Right, finish it off. I'm going to hide in the corner. Alright, I'm going to switch. Once again, switch to a... Oh, that one, that one. Right, that's going to blow up. Is it going to cause any secondary explosions? No. Well, that certainly took me long enough to get through there, didn't it? And now I've got, of course, there's going to be some radiation, so I just have to wait for a couple of moments while the rads calm down. Giddy up buttercup in here that I can't get. Not that I'd want to. Anything? Nothing useful on the desks. Folder, chair. Sprinter's leather right leg, that's not any use to me. Other than to weigh me down. Let's get rid of it. Get rid of that. God knows where the other robot flew off to. Right, but here we have the factory floor. Or one of the factory floors. Come on, you can take it out. Nice job. Right. Dead. And rather annoyingly, there's one right here.
Analysis read. Weapons free.
Turn around. Flame fuel. Knock that guy's hat off down there. Cool. Alright, so back to the shotgun. Coming up, we have another quick save area. It's very hard to sneak through here, mainly because stuff notices you. Stuff like what is about to come out of there. Say very hard to sneak through. Potentially if you don't have a companion it might be easier, but then if you don't have a companion and you're going through here at level 44 or 43, which is, you know, the level I'm going through at, then you will probably get mauled to death in an instant if you get caught. Right, now one of these drops down, there we go. Right, it's him dead. Come on, get over there. Hide the corner. Ah, great, you see me. Maybe if I say really, really still, it'll ignore me. Or I could just try and shoot the light on top of his head. Really, really still. There it goes. it's always in the scene, alright. In which case then I'm just going to have to shoot the top of his head off. Try to, anyway, if I can get a good line of sight on it. The wonders of cardboard boxes. Thankfully, tank bots don't nuke themselves, unless it's a legendary tank bot, which we hope it never will be. Because we don't like legendaries, even though we're playing on the difficulty that spawns legendary creatures, we don't like them. We really don't like them. Right, what did he have on him? Missile repair kit, row range also activated. Not much up in there, it's just a workbench. Yeah, take that. Obviously just workbench in there. And rover! Come on, 95. And into the next area. More duct tape, don't need the turpentine, thank you. You're having a bit of trouble out there, 95. What have you? Oh no, you teleported. Excellent. And here we are, the next locked door.
Use this.
And I'll probably be splitting this up into two, maybe even three parts, depending on how long the entire video recording goes for. Come on, I told you to use that.
Use this.
More overly secure doors. Here we go. Can't lift that door, it's a door without a handle on it. Another access point.
Here.
This is like another kind of just chamber or something. I suppose you're supposed to look down there and go, oh, look. Look at all the stuff we can see down there. That, I believe... I think that is actually the Mechanist's... his control center, I think, is actually down there. I believe that is actually the arena you go to. Anyway, another door open. Oh, I have to unlock this one, okay. There we go.
Yes.
Yep, and yep. Well, Mechanist, unfortunately your plan has gone awry. Oh, let's quick save because we can see. Kill junk bot, thank you. good. Let's head over here. Yay! Where's the jangles? Yeah, that's right. I'm up somewhere you can't easily get to, aren't I? Oh dear, have I destroyed your motivator? Oh, jeez, that's a big explosion. I think every time I'm going to kill a legendary creature, or a legendary robot, that's going to happen. Because I'm just not going to get away in time. Bit done. Now back up here. And we know he's about there. So. Round. Are you crippled? Have I crippled you? I have crippled you. Jeez, that explosion lasted, went a long way. Right, now he's out of the way. Yes, I know I'm dropping a lot of quick saves. Okay, still, oh, still got some rads in the area. Oh, I should vanish. Falling damage by 50%. Biometric scanner, not really that useful. I've wet myself down again. Just get rid of you. Don't know where the other robot exploded off to. Oh no, here he is. Front actuated frame. New mod. Tape, don't need any green paint. Another workstation, should you wish to improve your robot as you actually go through. I don't. Not much through there, I don't believe. We do have a come over here and say hi. Shells here, oil canister, various bits of other robot. Nothing of use. And I think this is another kind of a longer fight here. Yeah. Dropping all quick saves. Longer fight, but not that dangerous as I remember. Just kind of like a couple of little droids will drop down on you every now and again. You just need to blow them in there. See, there's one right now. Excuse me! Yeah, I hit that scrap bot. Thank you. well, you were still coming anyway. Have a fun ride. Oh, a fusion core. I think that's quite rare. Finding a fusion core on any of these. Let's get you. More Assaultron parts. And we need to go up there, basically. So we have to go around. Because the lift key, the lift carries cross is over that part. So you just need to just go around here. Up the stairs. I think there might be another robot at the top. Those are three radiation pumping devices. So I'm going to want to sprint past them when I get the chance. About now. There we go. And not much up here. Faculty's director's holotape. I'll take that. Is this a straight up one, maybe? Yeah, it is. It's a straight up one.
Nice.
Cool. I don't think I've got my... I didn't bring Sean with me, so it's not going to be an awful lot of use. But, you know, better than nothing. Oh, I think I can upgrade my gun, though, while I'm here. Ah, no. Left all my screws at home. How annoying. Okay, so I can't do anything with that. Never mind. I was hoping I'd be able to increase the range on it.
Maybe getting closer, but I will not falter. My robots will see to it that no further harm will come to the Commonwealth. I believe that good will always overcome evil. Justice will prevail today.
Yeah, screw you. Right, you on. Because we're moving. Last couple of times I ran through here, 95 just hung around over there or fell off. And it was like, oh, sorry, I'll have to walk all the way back up around again. So it's nice to make sure he's actually going to be on station with me. Even if the lift or carriage or whatever you want to call it is... rather shaky. Right, again, not much interest around here. There's another lock.
Use this.
And for some reason his voice module's not working. And another save. Can't remember what's on the other side again. Oh, okay, just another kind of view of the arena that you'll be in. Various gantries, walkways, various other stuff. Was there something moving up there? Oh, that's the production line now, of course, yeah. Again, another door you can't get through, and...
Over here.
Another lock. I don't think there's anything in here. Nah. Door opened by itself for me again. One time I've wandered through, it was like, go in here. It's like, alright then. Because in here we have personal storage with a whole bunch of ammo.
Psst. Think you can unlock that terminal?
Understood. Beginning requested task. Attempt failed. Repeating. Attempt failed. Repeating. Attempt failed. Repeating. Task failed.
Hey.
Affirmative.
Does that mean you can no longer do it?
See what you can do.
Understood. Error. Task impossible.
Okay, yeah. So you basically can't... You failed, failed four times and you can't get in. Shame. Because there's a whole bunch of ammo in there that you can have. Actually, is there any... No, there's not any more, okay. So, back out and back on the way. Again, just racks, test tube, various bits of science equipment, the charging station. And... a robo-brain operated gurney. Yeah, that's right. Now, so you see, this is where the place starts getting a little bit uncertain as to what's going on here. You can see here, there are ghouls. There are ghouls inside a whole mass of cages. What's going on? Why are there ghouls in cages? And more importantly, why is that one slightly glowing? I think that's because he is actually alive, is it? Is that one actually alive? One of these is alive. Yeah, it was that one. Now, you think, why are there so many... Oh, he's alive as well. Last time I went down here, there was only one of them alive. But why are there so many cages here? And, you know, this fella made a brave attempt to escape, but lost his head in the process. Well.
Hostile detected. All combatant safety can no longer be guaranteed.
Yeah. Well, the answer lies up here. So if you come all the way around, smashed up robots. No need to remain stealthy in this area. And have a look at the medical observation terminal. Subject A to... Now remember these. Remember these. Because I won't. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to scribble them down now as we go so I can write them. Because I know some of these come up later. So Subject A22. So A22... Convicted of serial killings in the DC area, not to be visited alone. Security personnel required for interview, so he was a serial killer. Serial killer. A22 shows higher brain function but weak constitution. We've been giving him a high protein diet and started session of electrotherapy to treat his muscles. Shouldn't be long until his brain survival rate for the procedure is no longer at risk. Remember that as well. Brain survival rate for the procedure. And next we have A53. Female, convicted for arson. Burnt down courthouse, leaving three dead. Only approach when sedated. And family medical history of dementia. Brain health is likely to decline or skew data. Recommend for termination. So they're just going to kill them. Because these are all test subjects. I'm not quite sure how they got down here. I haven't read that bit. So, A57 we have, convicted for murder of a waitress, prone to sudden outbursts of violence, recommends subject be restrained at all times or sedated, so just straight murder of waitress. Highly emotional, currently on cocktail of antidepressant and anti-anxiety, Dr. Asselford is starting psychiatric sessions to further see if she's a good candidate. Or brain procedures. A72. Committed a second degree murder while under the influence of alcohol. So, drunk murderer. And the subject displays high intelligence and knowledge of tactics. Slight signs of PTSD. Dr. Asselford to evaluate treatment. And final list. Blast, pressed the wrong bloody button. Go back in. Doesn't respond very well to the mouse, this. A88. Ex-military, so military person. Convicted second-degree manslaughter, assault resulting in hospitalization and later death of the victim. Highly intelligent, proved to be mentally sound, approved for candidacy. So remember those numbers. So what we've got here, I'm going to smash the terminal. So we've got five people who were held in these cells down here being evaluated for some kind of brain procedure. Now, what kind of brain procedure do you reckon there were down here? Considering what we have seen so far. In we go. Another dead fella. He's got a can on him. Come on, 95. Here we go. My eye just started hurting.
Yeah.
I'm in hay fever season. Blech. Now here we go. So another decontamination. And look what's around us. Medical facility. Lots of jars over there. An overturned gurney. That's the way we're going to want to go, I believe, later. Come through here. Operations terminal. Somebody lying down. Lots of surgical stuff. Brains. X-ray scans. Surgery trays. Lots of medical equipment hanging around in here. And if we go to brain extraction. Once again, thanks to equipment failures, we're getting pretty backed up in this department. The brain extractors were never meant to operate at this capacity. I think they've been running around the clock for the last few weeks. Usually end up with a prop blade from slicing through a particularly tough skull, or when the hydraulics in the pulling arm seize up when the spinal cord isn't fully severed and the brain is pulled out too early. I hope the Sirelletti doesn't yell at us again. This isn't our fault. We all had a pretty good laugh around the extraction department today. Ansel tried mixing some fresh biogel, a little bit of grenadine and vodka, and dared us all to drink it down. It turned out to be pretty good. Kind of thick and sweet with just the right amount of kick. We came up with a little game to try and name the drink. A whole bunch of stupid ones came up, of course, but we finally settled on Extractor Sunrise. Too bad we can't share with the other departments, but the biogel costs like $1,000 a pint, and I don't think Sirelletti would appreciate us drinking down some of her budget. Today was Holsey's birthday, so we made him a brain-shaped cake. Well, sort of. We actually just took one of the extracted brains and covered it in frosting. Of course, we didn't tell Holsey that, and the look on his face when you bit down the slice we gave him was pretty hilarious. It was a waste of a decent subject brain, but the prank was totally worth it. We really have some good times down here. I sincerely hope they don't reassign anyone away from the department. We're working well together, and our efficiency rating can't get much higher. Womack over in sanitation made an offhand comment that his job having to grab that was left of our test subjects and dispose them in the furnace felt wrong. Then, not a day later, I was sharing lunch with some of the personnel from the assembly division, and they asked me if pulling the brains from our test subjects' heads ever bothered me. I told them that it didn't. I'm not sure why some of the people in this project are having problems with what we're doing. Maybe they should look for work somewhere else. So, brain extraction crew. Bunch of a-holes. So they're responsible for pulling everything out. First of all, it starts off fairly simple, you know. You're trying to run us a bit too fast, the equipment can't keep up. And then, hey, let's try just drinking biogel. And then, wouldn't it be funny if we gave someone an actual brain for their birthday and watched them eat it? How hilarious! And by the end of it, they're just saying, you know, does it weird you out at all that you're getting people sent down here and you're literally just cutting their heads open and pulling brains out of living people? And they're like, nope. Total desensitization to the job. And here are a bunch of them. This is the brain extractor room. So some brains are sitting in jars there. Here's some, I believe there's some in here. Yeah, you can just about make them out. There's a couple in there that have been extracted, but didn't have anything done, because I assume the bombs dropped and the guys tried to get out and they all died. But look, it's just row upon row of brains in jars. And the cerebral reconditioning terminal. This is the one I told you to keep in mind about. So, reconditioning transcript number one. Subject A22, remember him? A22, our serial killer. Cirilletti, the lady in charge. Hello, can you understand me? What? Who is that? Where are you? I can't see. Oh my god, what have you people done to me? Calm down. I can't feel my body. I can't feel anything. What's going on? Please, this is horrible. A22, if you don't calm down, I'll have to turn you off. Turn me off? What do you mean, kill me? For the love of God, tell me what the hell you've done! Terminating A22. Subject to unstable. Subject A57. The lady who murdered the waitress. You're designated Unit A57, understood? Yes, A57 ready to accept commands. Excellent, A57. Initiate command diagnostic Zeta. Understood. 2 minutes passed with no input. This is taking too long. Please respond. Error. No command was provided and awaiting unit designation. Damn it. I think this one's short term is shot to hell. Dump it in the furnace and let's try another. Subject A110. Not one of the ones who were kept upstairs. Extraction is successful. No damage. Original Asian gender, 30 female. Alright, do you have any memories before your service in this facility? Negative, ma'am. Are you certain? Do a deep scan of memory banks. It's been reported that you are acting irregularly. Scanning now. Please stand by. Error. Unknown fragment detected. Error... what? This can't be real. My arms, my legs, they're gone. What's going on with me? Switching off. Aha, there it is. That was quadrant A987867756 in the temporal lobe. Can we get a tech in here to clear out the long term and tell them to stop being so sloppy about it? Subject A124, successful, no damage, 36 male. Recording now, repeat that again. I said, if you don't put me back in my body, I'm going to kill you, then everyone else in this place. Interesting, you do realise you're simply a brain attached to a vocal interface? You don't have the capability to perform these actions. I don't care. I'll find a way. And when I do, you will be the first to die. Wonderful. Simply wonderful. Lack of original body doesn't disturb you at all. No, it doesn't matter. Whatever it takes, I'll end all of you. Switching off. Excellent. As soon as you flush the long and short term, this one will be ready. Recommend sending along to Rawling's tactical team as soon as it's fitted to a chassis. So, get any ideas of what's going on in this place yet? We have brains being extracted. We have rather shady and murderous sounding individuals being tested on and attaching brains to chassis. Brain on a chassis. That's right. This place builds robo-brains. And they've got a couple of test subjects in there. More brains. This, very curiously, I can only assume this has been brought in by the Mechanist. Because if this was pre-war, there'd be no way they would have a Deathclaw skull having an x-ray. Because Deathclaws didn't exist. And I don't think there's anything really in here. Scanner, more brains. Brains in jars, another brain in a jar. Yeah, so there you go. This... look, just everywhere. Just brains in jars, being stored on trucks, trolleys. around the corner, furnace. And a grenade! Just to wake everyone up. Bloody robo brains. Oh shit, yeah, there's guns over there. I don't actually need to go that way. Yeah, my weight's still up a little bit. Damn it. 95. One down.
Non-combatants are advised to stay away. Weapons discharged. Hostiles neutralized. Recommend immediate repairs to primary systems to ensure
continuity. Ow. I wasn't able to back off then. Something was blocking me. Oh well, I guess we have to go. I'm not that far off level 44. That's not bad. But I guess we have to go again. Luckily I saved it just before going through the door. Otherwise that would be a mite irritating. Two more down here. That's woken the last one of up. I know I'm silent a lot in these. So that actually proved quite useful. Right. Flame fuel. So the shotgun actually is rubber and left arm. I don't... Oh no, I didn't have a rubber brain left arm. Okay. Sentry front hydraulic frame. I would like some tracks so I can actually make a proper robo brain. You know, and upgrade old Jezebel. But I haven't found any yet. Which is curious. Oh yeah, more brains. Working terminal, I can't do anything with. But I can get through here. Accessing system. And open the door, please. Yep, see, here we are. Robo brains coming out of production line, coming down here onto this device, whereby brains would then be locked in top. The first robo brain production facility.
Scan this.
I have to swap over my gun while I'm waiting. I've only got 162 rounds left in this thing, it's not a lot. I will not. Aha! And here we are at last. The Mechanist's lair. Now, if you'll excuse me, just before I start the conversation with him over there, I'm going to see if I can future-proof this place. So I'll be back in a moment once I have done what I want to do. Right, so here's what I've done. Mechanist is still in there waiting to start his conversation. I've snuck an order around here, over to the station, and I've just built myself 6 Protectrons to help me out in the fight. So let's see how well this goes.
The Silver Shroud. I cannot believe someone so respected, so honorable, would come here and destroy my robots. Your reign of terror ends here, Shroud.
The Shroud, as always, walks the path of justice. It is you who have fallen, Mechanist.
Lies, Shroud. Lies. The Commonwealth has suffered more than its fair share of injustices because of you. Now you'll face the full might of the Mechanist. My righteous robots will end your tyranny once and for all.
Right. Now let's see how well this goes. Shot one of my own ones. Okay, this is going a little bit worse than expected. Right. I probably shouldn't have started firing randomly into everybody. Sorry! Whee! Oh, the turret, okay. Turret bomb is hard. Okay, I think I'm dead. I'm gonna have to use... Well, I'm hidden at least.
Impressive. But I think you failed to grasp the full reality of your situation.
Nope, I'm pretty cool with the full reality of my situation, thank you. Sorry, I want to actually see if I can, mainframe. Can I actually shoot the, it's just going to cycle between them, isn't it? Can I actually shoot the spotlight?
Sparks! I'll deal with you myself! Come, my robots! Destroy her!
No, I can't. I cannot actually shoot the spotlight. Wow, and he just survived that one. Okay, down a couple more deathclaw stakes.
Reserve power at 34%.
Watch your step.
Warning. Critical power failure is imminent.
Damn it, Sparks! Throw everything at her! Everything!
It's not good. So I'll just lob a couple of mines. Head on me, I'll just lay some mines. I've got them, might as well use them. Oh, okay, yeah. Oh well, I think I was pretty screwed when that legendary one came up to me. Right, I'm back. Unfortunately, the game crashed. So we're back at the last autosave, and I hope it's going to be well enough for me to survive. Unfortunately, my frame rate has decided to drop significantly.
There is nothing you can do to stop.
Let's see how well these survive, shall we? Wait, what do you think you're doing? Right, okay. I am going to be back in a bit. I'll see if I can get my frame rate up so I can actually play the game properly, because at the moment it's sitting on like 13, so I'll back as soon as I can.
This entire for every robot you destroy, 10 more will come. Struggle all you want. There is nothing you can do to stop. Nothing.
Warning. Power generation capacity exceeded. Now drawing reserve power.
Sparks! I'll deal with you myself. Come, my robots. Destroy her!
Legendary last time, yeah? Legendary right there. So, it dropped a legendary on me. Way down there. Alright, okay. Here comes the jewel bot. Right, okay. Maybe don't dump all my mines until the jewel bot is coming? Getting beaten up, and where is my robot? Come on. Oh, it's you.
Bring the coils back around!
where my robot went. But maybe that other position is slightly a better one to hold, or I'll just have a look around. This looks like a better place to try and hold. They're only going to come from one direction.
Sparks! I'll deal with you myself. Come, my robots! Destroy her!
Slightly better for being in a situation here. I think this is the dual bot coming out. Dualbot. Holy Jesus! Was I that low on health? Alright, let's give it another go. It seems to be okay, kind of, defending this area. Although I do need to switch to a longer ranged weapon. Killed it. Right, I'm going to give the mind trick one last go. Right. damage. What? Okay, now it's the jewel bot. And why could I not fall off the end there myself? Take on legendary. I literally can't take on legendary level on my own at that kind of damage output. I'm going to cut the commentary here until I can finally get past all these guys. So back when I've done it.
I see the Commonwealth free of you.
I'm not a villain. I just want you to hear me out, face to face.
Very well. I will hear you out, but only for the sake of the Commonwealth. Sparks, with me. Silver Shroud is no common criminal. Let us discuss this amicably.
Unmask yourself, Mechanist, and stand ready for judgment.
You're right. I'm no match for the Silver Shroud.
There. Now we both know who we're dealing with.
Again, you cast me as the villain? Ha! But it is you with your rampaging robots!
No, that can't be right. The robots are programmed to protect. Their subroutines are clean. Observe, evaluate, and react accordingly. The testing was thorough. I ran every scenario. All passed.
The blood of innocence was spilled. Your own lackey confessed. Her twisted logic leading to tragedy.
Saving by killing? No, it's the logic. It's there. I can see it now. I was hoping it was the robo-brains, an issue with their memory wipes. But they were right. Their primary directive was flawed.
So, the veil is lifted, and the truth revealed. Your technological hubris is to blame.
I want to help the Commonwealth. And robots are all I know. I found this place, and figured I could finally do my part. I accept full responsibility. I can't take back what I've done, or even atone for it. But this doesn't have to end in violence.
Though your action initially appeared felonious, your intent was not. Seek redemption, Mechanist. You have much to atone for.
Done. Consider it done. And you won't regret this. I promise. None of the Commonwealth will. Here, take this. It's the password to the mainframe. You can use it to shut down the security protocols. I'd rather this place be in your hands now.
Well, there you have it. I finally managed to beat all the robots. It took a long, long time to do. It was that bloody jewel bot kept on coming up, but I just had to wait for luck of the draw, really, and not get a legendary robot with a face cannon. But yeah. A grand superhero battle. The Silver Shroud versus the Mechanist. And the Silver Shroud emerged victorious this day. And that will be where the gameplay element of this ends, because my hard drive is once again deciding it's going to run stuff and thus destroy the frame rate. So yeah, it's not a bad piece of DLC. I mean, it's the customization that a lot of people wanted for weapons in the form of robots. So, you know, any part with any part. That's what people wanted. It was rather short, though, I thought. You know, compared to, say, like, Big MT, or going into the El Dorado. You know, it's whatever the casino was called. It felt shorter because it was all kind of, well, you know, you pick up radio signal, you go out, you find a robot, fine, okay. And then you wander around the Commonwealth, you go to a building, kill some more robots. Wander around the Commonwealth, kill some more robots. Go to a building, kill some guys who, as far as I can tell, only appear for that mission. And then final mission. So while it was technically 25 missions, the middle three all kind of felt like they were just mashing into one. You know, initial mission, locate Ada. Fine, no problem with that. That was able to be done. missions 2, 3 and 4 of find the radio beacons, they all kind of felt the same. And then final mission, take on the Mechanist, which was, well, tough at over level 40 because of the top tier of robots spawning everywhere. Still, it was fun enough to, for me to see it through to the end. I'll have to wait for the next two DLCs to come out, see what they're going to be. Will I keep X95 with me? I may do. I may... Well, I've got to scavenge a lot of parts. I may make it better. I'm not going to put the sentry legs on, though, because... Probably going to have to go into a building for the other DLCs, and that means he's going to get stuck indoors. So, there you are. This was Automotron DLC. X95, the Mechanist, Sparks, and Mad Tina playing as a teched-up Silver Shroud. Once again, thank you for watching through this. I'll be back with the newer DLCs once again, with Tina running through, seeing what comes out, most likely dying horribly again. And I do hope that in the next one, I don't have to deal with exploding legendary people. But until then, thank you all for watching, and have a truly good night.